Welcome, Star Wars Force Arena players, to this brand new video. Today we are going right back to the start of the game and exploring some of the new leaders and new gameplay modes and all those kind of things in the game. So this video really is going to be aimed at players who are completely new to the game or who are returning perhaps after an absence of time and they're coming back and have maybe lost their account or started a new account. So if you do start your new account, you will be able to get Grievous and Anakin straight away. So at the start in the tutorial that I showed you, you select a leader. So for example, you selected Anakin for argument's sake, and then you level up with Anakin to the start when you go through the tutorial mode. And then what will happen is when you get your first pack, your first tier pack, you pick a leader, and then you can pick Grievous on the dark side, and then you go from there. And both opportunities will give you the chance to have uniques for either character. So for Anakin you've got Ahsoka, and obviously for Grievous you've got his IG-101 and 102 droids. As soon as I get Ahsoka up here on this particular... There she is. Hello. Perfect. There she is. So one of the things you really want to pay attention to when you're playing the game at the start is bear in mind you will be playing against other human players. And these players will have different skill levels, different card levels, different everything. So no two games will be the same. The important thing is that your strategy that you employ might need to change as you play against a particular type of leader who may be more powerful than you. So you might need to look at a hit and run approach and then just chip away. It's called chipping away at a turret. So you take bits off a turret at a time rather than doing a full-scale assault and getting completely wiped out in the game. And they're the kind of things you want to do, and I'll show you more about that in a moment. And with the important thing with this deck is now to remember is now Anakin's very low level with Anakin. I haven't used this character yet. I've been playing a bit of Grievous to start off. And when you start the game, you won't have many credits, you won't have many crystals, but you get those from playing the game, unlocking packs, etc., etc. And then you can spend them on the shop and buy new cards if you wish for credits. But don't go too crazy, because obviously the more you buy, the prices do go up. So I'd probably spend, like, for example, a couple here if I can afford it. And then wait for the refresh, which is an hour and 30 minutes. And if it refreshes these cards again, the prices will go back to what they were before. So 16 will be for them. And then you can buy them again a little bit cheaper. And then the next thing you want to do is look for a guild. Click the guild tab here. And you'll see some guilds here, like this one here, join instantly. But they do have what's called a requirement tier. So you have to be a Carbonite Challenger, which I think is tier 3, to be in this particular game. Guild. And if you aren't that tier, then you won't be able to apply. It's that simple. And you can have a look to see how active the guild is now. You couldn't do this before. You can see how active the guild is. So guilds that have players on like 10 minutes ago, a couple of hours ago, maybe even a couple of days ago, is pretty good to see. And they're the kind of guilds you want to be joining, ones that are active. What that allow you to do then is join a guild, and then you can take part in rewards, contribute to the guild rewards, trade cards with other guild members, earn a few more credits as well. So I can't join that guild because I'm too low level, but I have made an application to my own guild, which I'll accept later. So what you basically, if there's a guild that you want to particularly join that you know of, all you need to do is type the name in here. Like for example, I'll put in Galactic Menace, for example, which is my guild. But you have to type it out exactly as the name is spelt, because otherwise it won't find it. And you press search, and there it is. Now there is a space, but it's not for me. So if you wanted to apply in that guild, all you do is click on the guild, and it brings up the details, as I said before, and then you click apply. And then if it's instantly joined, you'll join it instantly. But this one is apply, so you have to apply to join that guild. And the guild leader may not accept your application. It can be a bit hit and miss. If you wish to create your own guild, it costs 5,000 credits to do that. So you won't find too many new players doing that right away, unless you sunk some money into the game on his account. And obviously when these packs you get later on, you just try and monitor them. 3 hours, 3 hours, 3 hours and 8 hours. So the 8 hour packs you ideally want to open overnight when you're sleeping. Same for the diamond packs, which are 12 hours and 18 hour packs, gold packs. You want to open those overnight when you're sleeping, because that way it just saves time, effort, and then at least your major packs are being unlocked. ready for the next day. So we're going to earn some crystals and have some battle rewards, which is a new thing in the game. And as you can see, I've played 4 games already. I've already earned 25 crystals, which is very nice, thank you. And we're going to earn another 50 by playing to the end. So one of the key things I always talk about in all my videos is making sure that whatever leader, whatever rank you are, so Anakin's level 3, for example, here, which tells you top left-hand corner under your name, level 3, there you go, and level 3 dark side right now. You want to make sure that your cards match or as close as match your level. And with those cards, we'll talk about your commons. So these, like the grey ones, are commons. So let's upgrade that for 20 credits. And obviously, the more you upgrade, the higher level you go, which adds to your defences. But you don't want to go too crazy, because if you are level 5 and your cards are level 1, you will fall short because you face off against a leader who's much more powerful than you and have much more powerful cards. So you will struggle. And with rare cards, you don't want them to be too far behind you. Again, you want them to ideally be a couple of levels below you, depending on your ranking and tiers, etc., if you're in the ladder. So it's upgrading for 300. I can't afford you, actually. 300 credits, wow. So let's level up you. Here's a common card, so we can do level 4, which is good. We've got 50 credits left. How much are you? Just about get you to level 3, so that's perfect. And then once you reach tier 2, you can then unlock the new slot and then move into the next game. And bearing in mind, obviously, you can't get having a full 8 slots yet because you haven't got the slots unlocked, but I have got increased attack power for units by 6%, which is good because of the era bonus that you get for each leader that you play. So what we'll do, we'll jump into a game. I've got a feeling it might be a game with a box. I'm only ranked level 1, so it will be straightforward. But we'll do that with actually, we'll play some Grievous, that's what we'll do. Because I've already played some games with Grievous, and I played against Jin. She was a human character. That's the first human character I've played. Everything else has been bots that I've played so far. And you will, at the start, level up rapidly to your tier because of the amount of points that are on offer right now is just crazy. So let's just jump into our first game. Forest Moon of Endor, when 1v1. See who we play against. So we're against a Luke, level 2, so there's a good chance he could be a bot, he could be another human. You can't take that risk. So let's go for it. So the map's a little bit different for lower levels. Now with General Grievous, you want to make sure that you're building up a little bit safe from the back. Like I deploy my weakest unit, Battle Droids here. Let's just take care of the Grenadier, because he'll literally kill all those Battle Droids in one go. Okay, that's fine. And then what I'll do, I'll drop my IGs over there. Because what they do is they'll wreck that turret top left. Now Luke's using his deflection there to deflect all the blaster fire, which is to be expected. But he's dead now. And as you can see there, look at those guys. They've just melted that turret up the top. So it's a nice little counter-attack there. Making sure now that all my energy is recharging at the bottom. So the turret's locked onto my unit there, so I'll just attack my special attack. Melt this turret down quickly. Luke's in a lot of trouble now. Now with Luke, you have to be careful for Luke. He's got Ben Kenobi, and Ben Kenobi will literally convert everything on the map. Well, not everything, but he can if he gets a good drop. So that only applies though, to what's called organic units, anything human or Wookiee or organic units, which we'll talk about in other videos. So this game's going to be over. This is a GG. Looks like Luke might be the bottom, I'm not too sure. But we'll take that. Good game. Thank you very much, sir. Always nice to be courteous in victory and even in defeat, no matter how salty you can be sometimes. Give him a thumbs up. So we've got 80 points. We've earned a battle reward there and 100 credits. And you can check the decks that the characters were using here. So pretty standard. So I think it was a bot. Very low level stuff. Although mine's pretty down there too. But it's a good win. Move into another game. And we now level up again to another division. And the higher we in the divisions we go, the chances of us facing off against humans, other humans, is going to be greatly increased. So you have to be prepared for that. It can kind of catch you off guard. And we are doing one of the mission chains as well. It's always good to keep everything in sync. So you're doing the missions, which contribute to your rewards, and so you don't sort of double back on yourself sometimes. Grrr 2. Okay, let's have a look at this layer. So we do Princess Leia. But Grievous is one of the new characters to the game. So let me know in the comments below what you think. Have you unlocked him yet? Have you used him in your combat? Got any questions about perhaps how to use him? So right now, I'll deploy my Manga guards at the back. Layers drop down a Wookiee. I haven't really got anything special here in my card deck, so what I'm going to do is just deploy and wait for it to drop some troops down, which she doesn't do, but I'll do that now. And then left hand side, I drop down my IGs again. Battle droids and support. Layers going to probably kill me here, which is not a problem, because she's occupied with all this going on. But top left, you'll see now, look at the guard just melt that turret. That is amazing. Now she's in trouble. You see. Now I can drop down some more guards here. Keep the pressure on the attack. Drop down my manga guards. Drop down some more battle droids. Take Leia down. This is going to be a GG. Pick up that health pack. You can't pick up anyone's health packs. Just because it's on their side doesn't mean you can't take it. So we'll take it. Gunship goes in. And that's going to be a GG. Now with General Grievous, he has got a bonus. All leaders have a bonus, a passive bonus, and that depends on the leader that you pick. Now with Grievous, his set bonus is, it gives, I think it's all droid units, 10% HP boost, and also you get, let's have a look, where is it? So here we go, I think it's here we go. They've reduced it, okay. So Cyborg General's a passive ability, so what that means is you don't press any buttons, it just does it automatically. So as it says there, all his tech units now get their attack power increased by 6% and their max health increased by 6. That's tech units. Now it used to be droids in the versions that I've been playing previously. And you can see here now all these have been converted to a tech unit from droid. It's a tech unit, so his unique will get a buff. These guys will get a buff because they're tech. That's a support card, so that doesn't get a buff. These guys are tech now, so they get a buff. So anything tech. So tech also includes tank. So that gets a buff too, because it's a tech unit. So always look for the category of what the unit type is. So for example, Stormtrooper won't because it's organic. This will because it's a tech unit as well. Which is pretty nice. Pretty nice. AT-ST, again, it's a tech unit, so that'll get a buff if you unlock that later on in the game. And they are tech, but you can't use them, and it won't get a buff in 2v2. Larry will get a buff because he's tech. And that's really how that bonus works. And with the Emperor here, for example, he has an ability too. So his is what's called unlimited power. So whenever an enemy or ally leader is defeated, Palpatine's attack power increases by 15% for 18 seconds. I mean, it disappears when Palpatine's defeated. So that's his special passive there. And everyone's got their own different things. So it's good to play around and find a leader that you will be comfortable with. So let's unlock the Dark Side mission. Collect our reward, thank you very much. Collected that chain there, so we'll pick this card free. Collect that, thank you. So you really want to make sure, though it's tempted to get maybe a card you haven't got, but if you haven't got many credits and you haven't got many units, it's always good to try and keep everything consolidated. That way you have a strong deck to use as a go-to when you need to win some matches. Do our daily, collect all. Got our first token there, thank you very much. So we can upgrade these, but I don't know how much it will be. Yeah, well, we can't afford that, can we? So we have to keep them at tier 1 for now. But when we get in a guild, we can earn credits from the cards and things that we exchange. Check the shop again, it refreshes in a bit and nothing's changed, has it? Nope. Okay, let's just move into our next game. See how we do here. In 1v1. So if you face off against a stronger opponent, as you will do sometimes, it's always good just to hold off your attack. Don't go in gung-ho because you'll just get obliterated. Just plan your attack, build up from the back slowly. So by doing that, by dropping units at the back, as I show you in this example now, slow-moving units like these guys at the back. Notice the movement. And at the bottom, my energy is recharging, you see, up to 8. So which means now I've got some support for them. So I put them down there too. Battle droids here to help me defend against this Wookiee warrior. But Leia's kited them. So what that means is she's where she's standing now, everything's gone to attack Leia. But while she's doing that, I'll come over here and hopefully my guards will discharge the turret. Yes, they do. Perfect. Simple drop down for more manga guards just to help keep Leia off back. Throwing those boys there as well. Give a special skill ability on Leia. That's going to really hurt. Manga Guard does die. Again, just simple click, deploy more battle droids. We'll take Leia's health pack. Thank you. We don't discriminate here. Again, simple click, deploys the guards in the middle of the battlefield there. Just do as much damage as we possibly can. Do an airstrike now. So if you want to attack the place you're already on, just click and it'll just automatically attack that location you're already on. I'm dead. But it was a good attack, early attack. Took out two turrets and almost on the shield generator, which obviously is the objective. But if we didn't take down the shield generator and the score stays the same, we will win the game because it's 2-0. So again, I'll build up from the back slowly. Leia is going to be in a lot of trouble now. She'll die there. There she goes. So we can go into this turret now and just finish this one off and finish the game off. Try and get an all four win if we can. That's going to be a GG. Pick up the health pack. Don't need to, at least will, so she can't use it. That's a GG right there. There you go. I think that was a bot as well we're playing against in that game. And what I'll do is in the next video, when I have some humans to play against, I'll obviously bring you that footage. So we've completed our battle reward now, all seven games. We've got 100 credits. Again, check out the decks we're using. Yeah, standard deck. So she was obviously a bot, I think. And what a bot is, it's just like playing against the AI. But lower level, it's a little bit easier to play against than it is in the main. Got a reward. So our crystals get added automatically. Thank you very much. And then got our daily mission. Click that one. Thank you. So we've got 600 credits. We could save our credits up to upgrade, but we haven't unlocked any new cards just yet from packs. So what we'll do, we'll save our money up because we really want to look at upgrading our Manga Guards and also our Umbaran soldiers would be nice. And also get some other, maybe look at the tank as well, using dropping a tank in a deck at a later date. And then hopefully get in the guild. And by being in the guild, as I said, all the games you play now will contribute to the guild reward. So thanks so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next Star Wars Force Arena as we continue the story of General Grievous. May the Force be with you.